mechanical pros. I got Matt here with me, and we're going to be going into breaking down industrial contactors and how to maintain them. Matt, tell me what we got going on here.
Thanks, Mike. Well, these contactors are quite common in the industrial and commercial chiller applications, also fans and other instruments. So the proper way, there is a proper sequence to disassemble this type of contactor and maintain it. So we'll get started. We'll go ahead and start disassembly.
And so what you got this one off of an old chiller?
Yeah, this is from an old train CBHE chiller that we converted to a VFD.
So okay, very cool.
I kept these as spares to actually demonstrate how, how we can pull these things apart.
And so this is a 200 amp?
Yep, 200 amp.
Okay.
So first off, we, we'll take the base off. And now we can start separating the components. Here we can see our contacts on both sides. These particular contacts do not have much wear at all. We would just require maybe some light cleaning, either with a wire brush or some Scotch-Brite.
So you just want an abrasive cleaner, and you're trying to get...
Yeah, not too abrasive. Some people will think, I've worn this down. Let's go ahead and put a file on it. But if you do that, you actually will change the mating surfaces, and you'll get end up with hot spots on your contactor.
So the goal is not to remove any metal. We're just removing any corrosion.
Yeah, any carbon built up.
Gotcha.
So there's your one set of contacts. Makes it a lot easier. Go ahead and clean with a wire brush, spray with some contact cleaner afterwards, make sure there's no oil or anything like that.
Okay.
If you can notice that one side is wider than the other, as far as knowing how to put it back together, these are very simple contactors. There's only one way to take apart, one way to put back. Most part.
Yeah.
So we got that, but we need to be able to check the magnet frame coil. To access that, we have to take off the two center flash guards. And that will enable us to get to the screws that hold the magnet frame to the housing. Always do this in an area where you're not going to lose screws and washers. These parts are small, and they will, when they come apart, they can roll a long way in a mechanical room. So we've got those loose. Now we can flip this over, pop these two screws out. Notice we've got these little washers there. Make sure there's a spring washer and a flat washer on both of those. And now we can flip over this way and gain access to the rest of the contactor.
So how often would you do this?
This is an annual maintenance that you want to look at. Now you can take the magnet frame assembly out. This is your movable part. This also only goes in one way. If you try and put it back the other way, it will not go. So very easy. This is your coil for the contactor. One of the most important things is these laminations over time can get some wear. These spring retainers right here hold the laminations together. A common problem with these contactors is these springs that hold this all together will actually come apart in the contactor. They can work their way into the contact, cause some severe issues. When they do start to loosen up, you will not have an audible, loud buzzing noise in these contactors. So during maintenance, you want to make sure all this is clean, that we don't have any extra metal, dust, or whatever. There's a retaining plate there. That's a bottom magnet frame.
Okay.
The one part we can put it back incorrectly is the spring on the bottom of the magnet frame. You want to make sure that this is facing back up to the metal side. If we flip it over this way, these two edges will actually rub on the plastic and cause a lot of dust.
So this thing's got a little, it's got a convex to it. And so you want, which position do you want it in?
So ideally, the only way is to have the concave part facing the bottom. After you've taken this apart, of course, you want to spray this clean, make sure there's no dust, and we'll start putting it back together. So get that, get your magnet frame. Magnet frame's not, it can go either way.
So if you're going to use a spray, are you using compressed air? What are you using to clean it?
You want to use a contact cleaner that dries and leaves no residue. So be particular with that. Lint-free rag, so you don't leave lint inside.
Is there a certain contactor spray you like?
Yes, a new Calgon.
Okay.
Is my favorite brand. It comes in a decent sized can. You can get multiple contact cleans out of it.
Okay.
Yeah, so going back again, we've got our magnet frame back in there. Go ahead and inspect this, make sure we don't have any cracking, overheating. This is our contact points for the coil voltage. So if you do see any failures like that, then go ahead and change that out.
Yeah, so if you were to find like cracking or any kind of severe damage, at what point would you somewhat condemn it and just start over again or replace a part?
The worst damage where you would not be rebuilding the contactor, you can buy all these parts still individually. But if I started to see a lot of wear on the sides here, there's also, if the machine has vibrated a lot, it actually will wear the space between here and here, and this will become very sloppy.
Okay.
And then, once that's worn out, it's hard to find these parts though. The coil, the magnet frame is fine, but if that has decent wear to it, then let's just go ahead and put a new contactor in there.
Yeah.
So that goes back together like that. Oh, I did forget one thing. Very important is your holder for your magnet frame. You can go ahead and put that cover back on. This also can only go one way. If you notice, it won't fit down properly. Now we've got that. One of the most important parts is getting these two screws started. So because that has a bit of a leg in it, you want to be able to pull those up evenly. So you want to get these started evenly. You just don't want to tighten down one side all the way at once. So go ahead, get them started.
So you want to bring them down together, tighten it up together.
Correctly. So if you happen to put it at an angle, it's not going to hold that magnet frame in correctly, and it's going to cause you problems when your contactor tries to pull in. On a typical contactor, you won't find these flash arc protectors as clean. Go ahead, get a small wire brush, clean all the carbon off. Carbon will track electricity when it gets any kind of humidity to it. So if the contactor's been off for a while, you get a lot of carbon, it's a chance that you may even cause an arc flash issue between the phases.
Yeah.
So very important to clean all that carbon off. These particular screws have a coarse thread. Putting these back together is very easy to strip these. So I'm very particular in putting these back together where I do not strip that. You can clean those, put these back together.
So if you get, you know, if you have moisture, electricity, and heat, you're going to get some carbon.
Correct.
You're going to manufacture carbon, yeah. So you want to get that carbon off so you have a clean surface that's contacting every time you need it to contact.
Yeah. You will get, you know, buildup of heat if you do not keep these clean.
Uh-huh. Or
other thing that you should take note of is if you look side on, you can see the how much left of the contact we have. These ones have very little wear. That you can see the silver part that mounts onto the copper contact base. You want to look, make sure there's no major splattering. It should be even wear across all the contacts. Then again, you know, if you get where your contacts are worn out, you can order a contact replacement kit.
Yeah.
And yeah. And sometimes you have to play around, get those started, and that completes that. Always check your where your coil is going to mate into these. These are spring-loaded connections. Just make sure they're not worn out. You can slide that back. If everything's put back correctly, we should be able to manually push the contactor in. Of course, you want this being locked out electrically wise. You should have a nice,
all right,
smooth operation.
There you go. That's how you you break down, inspect, and maintain a industrial contactor. Thanks, Matt. Yeah. Appreciate it.
Thank you.
Hit that like, hit that subscribe. Come back, check us out for some more tips of the trade, and check out a Mechanical Pros. Thanks so much.